now we're gonna find the extrema of these given functions and values. So first before we get the extrema of this function, we need first to get the critical point. So to get the critical point, we need to derive the function first. So let's go and derive it. So to derive this function, we need to use a cosine rule. Okay, so let's go. So cosine rule says that we need to copy the denominator and derive the numerator. So which is 1, then subtract it 2, then copy the numerator and derive now the denominator. This is like an alternating process. And then over the square the denominator like that. So by observing the functions, we can observe that we can cancel this x right here, and what we have left is negative 1 over x square. So now what we are going to do next is to equate the first derivative into 0. 1 over x. So equating it to 0. So to get its critical point, we need to use the algebra manipulation. So as we can see by this function, it is actually negative 1 equals to 0. Simply means a false statement. Negative 1 never be equals to 0. So it is just means that we don't have a critical point. No critical point. So we don't have any number that we're going to add up instead of this interval values. So now what we're going to do is just simply use this interval values, which is 1/2 to 2. So let's do and plug it in. So first I'm gonna erase this one. So what we are going to do is probably like this. We need some table like this. And put the 1/2. Let's make this a short one. 1/2 and 2. So now what we are going to do next is to plug in these values into its original function. Not the derivative one, but the original function, which is this one, the x plus 1 over x. So now let's go and plug it in. So 1/2 plus 1 is equals to 1/2. So we just only use a algebra, simple manipulation, to simplify this expression. So 1/2 plus 1 is actually 3/2, and then over 1/2. So 3/2 over 1/2. We can do like this. 3/2 times 2/1 is actually equal to 6/2. So 6/2 is just simply equals to 3. So we have a value of 3 right there. So now let's move on to 2. So 2 plus 1/2 is just simply 3/2. Okay, we have a value of 3/2 there. So now let's focus to this table. So upon observing the table, so what we can actually see is just a 2 x values and the 2 y values. So we can see that this is the highest number and this is the lowest numbers. So since there's only 2 values, we can conclude that the maximum is 3, which is actually the highest one, and then the minimum is 3/2, which is the lowest one. Okay, so this is actually what the extrema means. Extrema means that getting the maximum and the minimum. So extrema, it's like in calculus, it is the point where the values is the largest or the smallest. So that's it.